every now and then. I come across something that takes me way beyond the edge of creativity. Way beyond anything I could have even thought or imagined. Oh man, sparks my interest. Today, that thing is Minimal Audio's Morph EQ. Let it take you there. Now, before we get into the video, you know you gotta like, you gotta share, you gotta subscribe, you gotta leave a comment. You already know these things. I don't even have to tell y'all no more. You already know what it is. Now, I just like to start off by saying this is not your regular EQ by far. It's an EQ that's built for movement, like filtered movement across the wavefile of sound that morphs the sound into something different. First is very innovative. The crazy thing is that it allows you to draw these endless movements, these endless patterns that you can create with the sound of EQ. It's crazy. You can actually navigate it with a knob that's on the EQ. I've never heard anything like this before. Matter of fact, it's like macro control. It sculpts the audio. It sculpts the audio as a whole, across the whole thing. Globally, across whatever that sound is, and you can shift it with movement. It's crazy. I've never heard anything like this before. You can actually create paths that you want a part, like a filtered part, to actually go in. This is just the craziest thing ever. You can control filter cutoffs, and you can create wide stereo effects. You can even use Morph EQ to mix and match combinations through all, like from the bass to the highs to the mids, however you want to do this thing. It is all up to you. And to add insult to injury, there's like over 100 presets. So you already know we got to take a look at it and break down all these little parts of this just to get the idea of what we're talking about. Shout out to all the guys over at Minimal Audio for sending this to your boy. So you already know we got to dive into it. Let's do it. All right, man. So I have this pulled up on this particular pad here. And what this pad does is I'll play it without it just so you can kind of hear what it sounds like. Now, as you can see, it's just a pad. It goes straight across. It doesn't have any movement. It has just this regular pad. And so what I'll do is go ahead and turn this on and show you the actual movement that I drew in. Now, that's crazy. That's insane. And the crazy thing is that at the very beginning, when it first comes on, I have a different pattern and it sounds like this. Man, that is insane. It gives it a whole nother kind of feel to it. The pattern that you see, if you look at this, I have this little red thing going just up here, then down here, and it just goes up and down, right? So the original pattern starts here where the circle is, and it goes here, then here, then here, then here, then here. And I just kind of played around with some sounds on it just to kind of see what it would do. And that's what I came up with that sounded pretty good. On the other one, I had this little pattern here, and as you can see, as I highlighted, it shows the actual pattern that it does. If you have like this one, I didn't do anything to this one. It just comes straight across. This one goes from here all the way around to those patterns there, just like that. And so if I turn this morph button, you'll see it changes all of the patterns all the way across. Now that's bananas. So if I, let's see, let's go back to the red one I did here. So as you can see, the highlighted area right here in the white is what it's following. This is your automation that you're creating, and it follows that. And that's pretty cool. Now, there's some things I want to go over and just kind of show you what it is. So I'm going to go to one that's completely empty, and then I'll show you every knob and what it does. So as you see, there's one that's completely blank. I have no movement on it at all, and it's just the vocals. I'll play it for you. And it just repeats itself, right? So we'll go ahead and go through each part of this and just kind of break down what it does. So if I go through the presets, you'll see morphing, and I can just choose one, and it has patterns that are set up, and it does the same thing. It just goes back and forth. You can, that's crazy. Let's choose, let's go to the very first one, alternator. This was crazy. This is a wild one. Now, this is the morph button. So as you see with morph, it's going to take it in the pattern. It's not going to shift anything. You got all kind of different buttons here that will do all of that for you. So morph is just going to follow the pattern that you have set up. Then you have shift. Shift is going to shift that pattern. So if I have this same pattern set up, you will see that I have shifted this to different parts of the EQ settings here, right? Now, you also can have pinch, which will shorten it up, tighten it up. It's going to tighten it up or loosen, depends on which way you go. And that's going to bring it in or take it out, right? Then you have spread, which is going to spread it out. It's going to go from left to right. You can go either way and it'll take it as far as you can spin this little knob here. And then you have scale, which is going to take it up or down or in reverse. However you want to do that, it will do that. So all these different knobs play a part in the actual pattern that you play. You create a pattern, shift will do one thing, pinch will do one thing, spread will do something else, and scale will do something else. Of course, at the bottom here, you have your dry, wet. So if I have a pattern, turn that off, it's dry, and now it's wet again. Shift back here. As you can see, it spreads it out. And if we do, we'll just loop this so I can show you some different things it does. The shift. And this is just all a part of the EQ. Your pinch. Spread it. We can scale it. So as you see, you got all these different things that you could do with it. You can go wild with this. You can create as many different patterns as you want with this. Now, I will tell you also, each individual pattern flow or click that you put in, you can, it has unlimited spots that you can take it to. All right, so we have an empty slate here. We're going to create a pattern for this particular loop that we have and just kind of see what we come up with, just to get an idea of what it sounds like when you create a pattern and how to actually create a pattern also. So here we go. So first thing we're going to do, we're going to play it. You'll see your wave is here. This is where the sound is. So I want to click somewhere in that sound, right? So I double click. It's going to give me a little button here. This is regular EQing. Regular EQing. You can do however you want to do this and create some EQing. So let's just say you have that. First thing I want to do is I want to click on the outside of this red little line here, and I want to draw a pattern here. It's going to come here. Then it'll come here, and I can also hit Command or Alt, depending on which, if you have Mac or app, Mac or Windows. And if I hit that, I can click somewhere and it will create that pattern there. Now, I can go wild with this. Right? Again, unlimited clicks, right? I'll create another one, double click here. Same thing. I want to go here, 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 here. Just creating some, right? Do another one. We'll make it go up and down. Same spot. Now, as I've created this, now if I go ahead and start doing morph, you'll see the patterns that I created is what it will do. Here we go. So now that I've created that, if I, again, if I want to shift that, I can shift it to the right or left. That's more in the file there. Now I can go same pattern, right? I can pinch this, make it smaller or bigger. Let's go ahead and pinch it. All right. We can take that pinch, we can spread it, same pattern. That's pretty cool, right? And so now we can do scale, smaller or bigger, but it's still the same pattern. Oh man. That's crazy, man. This is stupid. Also, you can go over here and create more dots, do more dots, and you can go here, click on all of them. You'll see all four of them there. You can also go by the type. These are low pass, band pass, high pass, all that good stuff. You got your frequencies here. You can dial those in. You have your gain. You have where you can do the gain, you can do left, right, stereo, mid, side, or you can delete the last one in that order. You can go forward, backward, however you want to do it. It is all there. You have input, output gains. You can come up here and save this, and you can save a file on it under whatever you want to save it under and go crazy. Go crazy, man. This thing is insane. All right, man. So again, shout out to Minimal Audio for creating this thing. They sent it over to me. I appreciate it. I hope that this really explained it to a point to where you guys can get it and use it. Right now it's running for $49. That is the price that it is right now. I don't know if it'll go up or down. But man, $50, bro, you are well within the range of $50 and you can get this. This thing is crazy. This is an investment that you have to make. It will transform the sound of anything that you have. You can come up with all kind of stuff, man. Minimal Audio has got a lot of creative things over there. We have Riff. We've been using Riff and it is distortion times 100. I don't really know what the heck they be going on over there, man, but Either way, man, go get it, man. Minimal Audio, and you can get this for 50 bucks, man. Now, I have one question for you. What will you do with your creative spaces? Peace out.